In the oldest days, they literally the physicians would taste the urine to see, you know, if there was sugar in the urine to diagnose or, you know, understand how bad a person's diabetes was. We're at the point now where, you know, with a body-worn sensor, every 5 minutes, a perfectly accurate glucose reading is captured. And that reading is communicated to an insulin delivery device that can decrease insulin and very soon increase insulin. So it essentially becomes an artificial pancreas. My name is Dennis Salotti. I'm the Chief Operating Officer at the Avoca Group. I am an adjunct professor in the MS in Clinical Research Organization Management Program through Drexel. Before we had all the fancy technology around wearables and sensors and all these sorts of things, your doctor would sit you down and ask you, well, how's it going? On a scale of 1 to 10, how much pain do you have? That became kind of the characterization of the patient experience was these, you know, these questionnaires, if you will. Where we've kind of evolved to now with wearables is the opportunity not to interrupt a person's day to say, hey, you know, don't forget, you know, we need you to tell us about how, you know, how it was to get dressed this morning or how easy it was to walk to the bathroom. Now we have the opportunity to put something on someone that makes observations about what's going on. By making those observations and collecting enough data, we can then kind of infer what's happening with that patient. You know, are they moving more today than they were yesterday? If we give enough people that drug, is that drug making people move better, move more, you know, or not? And is that improving their patient experience? Is it lessening pain or increasing mobility? You know, those sorts of things. So I think the field of clinical research is going to change with greater adoption of wearable technologies, because I think what I see is it has the capacity to reduce the burden on patients, participants in clinical trials. And what that I think will do is help address one of the perennial problems in clinical research, which is getting enough participation. The faster you can recruit people into a clinical trial, the shorter the duration of that trial is going to be. The idea that wearable devices combined with what we're doing with data science, combined with the fact that, you know, we're looking at the integration of clinical care and clinical research, all of these things, the confluence of all of them, are really changing the clinical trial landscape. And I think what it's going to look like in 5, 10, 20 years is going to be totally different as a result of this. I think things are going to happen faster. I think we're going to be able to streamline and probably improve quality. And that, I think, is going to be, you know, not just beneficial to the clinical research industry, but I think beneficial to everyone.